give us some possible other big arcs that you guys might explore in season 2.
What more do you want, man?
Give me it all.
Showing what Barry saw in the Speed Force was really important for us. You know, one of the things that we've, we haven't been shy about is really embracing, some of the pivotal comic book stories, from the various runs over the years. I think that it's not like when you adapt a novel for a movie or, you're literally adapting like that one story. You know, you've got 75 years with some of these characters of various stories. As you see, there were large parts of, certainly of Rebirth, in season 1, and we're not going to stop doing that. And there's some pretty iconic stuff that's obviously we're twisting as we do, coming up in season 2. But we're just really excited.
You guys shifted away from kind of a villain of the week format early on to a more serialized, broad sci-fi approach. Is that good? Is there going to be more of that in season 2 now that you've established the overall tone of the show?
There was always a serialized tone. I think what tends to happen just on any of these shows, and certainly it's the same on Arrow, is that there's a tendency in the beginning to have a little bit of villain of the week while you're setting up all of your emotional cards. Part of the reason it worked so well in the back half of the year where it became much more heavily serialized was because of all the groundwork that we laid in the beginning of the year and making sure that you understood who these people were and what they can do and what their relationships were with each other. So now we're not starting from a dead start. We're building on season 2, so we have all the momentum and all the storylines that we're bringing across. And then, there will be some villains of the week early on, but how and why they're there is part of an overall mythology. So I don't think it'll, those early episodes are going to feel disconnected from one another. I think that the success of The Flash and the secret of the secret, because you all watch it and you like it. I think it's part and parcel of the show that, like, it's just not, like, closed-ended episodes.
But Tom is obviously here.
Tom Cavanagh.
Yes.
Who was erased from existence at the end of last season. Tom Cavanagh.
Yeah, that one. So, hypothetically, what can you say about how he might be factoring into The Flash season 2?
Tom Cavanagh is. It continues to be a regular on season 2. I think, how he comes back is going to be something we're really proud of and we're very excited about, and Tom's very excited about. So much of the success of this show was Tom's portrayal, of Thawne and Wells, and that relationship that he has with Barry, and certainly the relationship he has with Justin Martin, and that will continue. In the form in which it continues, I think, again, we want people to be able to enjoy it on its own terms, but I think that it's just the nature of storytelling today with kinds of TV shows that, like, I'm sure people, when they saw the pilot, were like, oh, well, they'll figure out he's the Reverse Flash in year 4 or something, and John will get out of jail in the series finale,
Last questions. Okay.
Those things, especially with Tom and, like, the revelations and their climax, all that stuff happened a lot faster, in some ways it seems like maybe it ended, but what's great about this show and what's great about the Flash properties is that there's always new ways to twist the stories and keep going.
Could any characters from the Smallville universe show up now that there are multiple universes?
I don't even know if that's legal.
How soon will we meet Jay Garrick?
Who says you will?